My name is Utsakua. My name in English means born before her time. And I tell you that I'm a member of the Blackfeet Nation, the Omskup of the Gaia. And the name of our tribe is Nzitsitapu. It means the real people, the first peoples of this continent. And so I come to you today. I'm from Montana, from the Blackfeet Reservation. I don't know if you all know, but in Montana there's 7 different tribes, and my tribe has one of the largest land bases. We have over 1.5 million acres. We sit real close to our reservation runs right. You know what a reservation is?
Yeah.
Yeah? And where I'm from right now, it's snowing. There's 4 feet of snow there today. Can you guys imagine that? It's probably something that you wouldn't, or a lot of you probably haven't experienced. But I come here today, I've been invited by Herman Padilla. I'm very honored to come here and to speak to young people. I belong to a group of people from my reservation. This group of people is called the Brave Dog Society. In this society, our main purpose is to watch over the children and to protect them and to make sure that the well-being is being looked out for them, for all of our people. We have, our reservation has over 7,000 people living on it, but we have 14,000 members that are enrolled. But I come here today to speak to you about why it is we do what we do in order to educate ourselves. Me, I come from a place where my grandparents and my mother and my father's parents too, that they spoke English, but very broken English, for the fact that our first language is our own native tongue. Just the same as a lot of you, your native tongue is Spanish, because that's the language of your people. Well, me having been brought up in that environment, it made it difficult for me when I went to school, because everything was in English. And because we spoke broken English at home, when it came time for me to get into junior high and high school, I struggled in those areas of English, and especially grammar. Understanding the language was difficult for me. But I made it through. I got through it. And then something miraculous happened to me. I would say it's now been since 1999. It's like something happened to me in my life, whereas I could see clearly, like there were things that were removed from my eyes and where I was able to see clearly. And I started to look around me at the things that I thought were normal on my reservation, and they weren't normal anymore. I started to see that our children were having many problems. They were having problems in reading and writing and studying. They were having problems with math and science. And not only the children, but the adults too. The adults were already growing up and they didn't have any skills that would help them survive in this world today. You know, you see how I'm dressed today? I'm dressed traditionally. This is the way that my people dress before they encountered the Europeans. My people dress this way, not necessarily with these flashy of materials like I have on, but they did wear these type of materials. But today, I live in two worlds. I know this world, the traditional world, because this is very near and dear to my heart. It's very important that I know who I am and where I come from in order to really stand straight and tall in today's world. But I also am educated in the world of today, the technological world, where we have to know how to use computers and how to write correctly and read and study so that we can better ourselves and become what it is that what we want to become. As for me, when the obstacles were removed from my eyes and I started to see clearly, I started to realize there were a lot of problems amongst my people. One of them was drinking. Another one of them was drugging. Another one of them was the lack of education. And so I asked Creator to help me and to guide me and to direct me. And that's how I ended up here in California. I came here to California to learn skills that will help my people. I've learned how to, basically now I'm a professional tutor, but I learned how to teach kids and adults how to read, write, and study, and communicate better. I've also learned how to help people to get off of drugs and help them to reestablish their lives so that they can become successful members of society. And all of this, I had to reach for it and I had to want it. But the Creator inspired something in me that made me want to help the people. And each and one, every one of you today, here in this room, you all have gifts. I want you to know that. I want you to truly know that you have a gift. And you search long and hard enough, you will find that gift, that color that you have that will bring you to who you really are so that you can make a difference in this wonderful world that has problems. But it's up to each one of us. We all are responsible for everything that occurs in our life and everything that is happening outside of our lives. We are responsible. And it's up to us to make a difference. The Creator's gift to me is the gift of being able to see the truth and the willingness of heart, spirit, and mind for wanting to help. For the last 7 years, I've been away from my reservation to everything that I've known and loved my entire life. But it broke my heart to leave. But I had to leave and I had to come to California so I could learn. So I could learn and I could put myself in a position where I can help my people. Our people. We need to help ourselves so we can help our people. I look out in this audience today and I see you all, and I'm looking back at myself. You're the majority of you are the same color as me. You're the first peoples of this area, this country, or this area here. The majority of you, your families, your ancestors, walk this area before other people walk here. So this, in the essence, is your, it is your reservation, your area, and the people are yours too, because we have to take the responsibility. It's not only about ourselves, but it's about helping the people. Part of this journey has been learning. Another part of it has been spiritual. Everything I have on here today is spiritual. I come to you dressed in the armor of my people. These right here, you see these on my grave holders? And I don't know if you guys seen it, but I have these on my feet too. I don't know if you've seen them. The designs are the designs of the mountain. And that's the area around my reservation, surrounded by mountains. And you see right here, this is on my hand and on my wrist, and on my other fingers. These are called the medicine wheels. The medicine wheel is very healing. As you can see, there's four different colors. There's red, black, and white. In mine, I have silver, but it's usually yellow. The red represents the people of our color, the red nation. The yellow would represent the Asian nation. The white would represent the Caucasian nation. The black would represent the black nation. In my way of learning and what I've been taught by my grandfathers is that when these races come together and when they learn to love and respect each other and when they learn to share each of their gifts, in my way, the black nation is gifted with strength. The white nation is gifted with intelligence. The red nation is gifted with spirituality, and the yellow nation is gifted with emotional understanding. In our rights, when all these four nations come together and love and respect one another, that is when the true gifts that Creator gave all of us and each of us will really flourish and become to be, and that will be a healing time of the entire earth. It's when all four nations come together and share their gifts with each other.